In this video, I'm TIG welding some 18 gauge cold rolled. That's just a little bit less than 50 thousandths of an inch. I'll be doing some flash tacking and kind of going over how that works. Flash tacking is just tack welding sheet metal at high amperage. So a part of that equation is a nice, clean, sharp electrode. You don't want any misfires when you're doing this. I'm set up with a number 5 gas lens cup, and you can notice I've barely got the electrode sticking out the end there. I chose a number 5 just to save a little gas, and so I'm going to reduce my flow down to a little bit less than 10 CFH, probably more like about 8 or 9. And with a nice soft flow of gas, that also helps avoiding misfires. So it's just a really quick tap of the foot pedal. I use the cup to prop against that outside corner joint, and then I rock the electrode in till it touches, and then pull it back just a little bit, just a whisper, and then blast it really quick with the foot pedal. And it leaves a nice, small, perfectly clean tack. Hardly puts any heat into the metal at all. Doesn't distort anything, doesn't melt through, and it speeds things up a whole lot when you're dealing with tacking joints like this on sheet metal, especially on stainless. Once again, I rock the cup end to touch the electrode, pull back just a little bit of a gap, and blast the foot pedal. Now, because you're using such high amperage, it does pay to practice on some scrap metal before you do this on anything important, and you can't have a gap at all. You've got to really pay close attention to corner to corner, fit up with no gap, and a really tight arc length, and you got to get on and get off. You can't hold the foot pedal down more than maybe a tenth of a second or so. There are machines out there that have spot timers on them for doing this operation, and it's pretty helpful. Once you get it dialed in, then there's no guesswork. Then you just press the foot pedal and it just does it all at once, does it all for you. You don't have to press the foot pedal all the way down or let off or anything. Just tap it or even use a torch switch. The machine I'm using today does not have a spot timer, so I'm just doing it by manual. Just tapping that foot pedal and then getting off of it really quickly. This is a copper spoon that I got from Harbor Freight. Unfortunately, I don't think they sell them anymore. This is one of the best deals they had. For about $10, you could get this nice piece of copper with a handle on it. And super handy for using for backup, for filling in holes, and for jobs like this where you hold it right next to where you're going to arc off. Maybe somebody still has. I think maybe Eastwood has a version of this, a little bit more expensive, probably still worth it. Now, I usually tack it about once every inch or two, but sometimes you have to tack it really close together as I tap it with a hammer and work out any potential gaps that are in there. Now I'm going to switch over to a Jazzy 10 ceramic. It's a number 10 cup with an extra couple of diffusers in there that makes a heck of a difference when it comes to shielding. I'm going to use about 20 CFH for this 10 cup, and that's about what I would use for a number 8 gas lens. So it doesn't require any more gas than a number 8. For this first outside corner joint, I'm using these big chill blocks here. One of them's clamped on, another I'm just laying on there. They don't really make perfect contact, but they still make a big difference in sort of trapping the argon envelope and also drawing a good bit of heat away. You can see it's a little bit blue, a little bit silver here and there, but that's probably where it's touching and where it's not, but it still makes a big difference. I was full pedal at 55 amps, and it seemed like I wanted just a little bit more, so I'm going to increase it to 60 amps for the rest of this joint. I'm using 045 diameter ER70S2 filler and a 332 diameter 2% lanthanated electrode. You saw that earlier on how that was tapered. And those chill bars are really making quite a difference. And the reason I say that is because I welded some without any chill bars here, and that's coming up soon. You can see the distinct difference between this and what I'll weld without any chill bars. But before we do that, let's just take a look at the filler rod hand here. When I'm welding a really small puddle like this, what I'm doing is I'm dabbing the filler rod in the puddle, and then when I pull it out of the puddle, I do the feeding operation with my fingers. So I don't feed it in there with my fingers. I dab it because I'm a little bit more precise when I'm not flicking my fingers around. I dab it and then I choke back and feed it when the rod's out of the puddle, if that makes sense. I say that because sometimes on a heavier aluminum joint, I won't worry about that. I'll just push it in the puddle because I'm pushing so much more rod in with aluminum. Here I'm welding, obviously, with no chill bars at all. Same cup, same everything else, but just no chill bars. And it's welding up just fine. Puddle's staying pretty clean and everything. But you can just notice a distinct difference in the discoloration of the weld bead. It's all gray and dull, as opposed to being nice and shiny with a luster. For carbon steel, that doesn't necessarily mean it's worse or better or anything like that. It's just, we always strive to do as good as we can. So the chill bars do make a difference. And then about this time, it occurred to me that I made this little handy little thing here a good while back, and I had to hunt it up. It was in the bottom of a toolbox. Just some copper bars, and just made for outside corner joints like this, and it's just really handy. It's, again, it doesn't touch. It doesn't come into complete contact, but it still does a great job. I'm going to set this piece up to where I'm welding completely flat, and an easy way to do that is with these magnetic V-pads. I added these to the store fairly recently because they're just so darn handy. Also, these Knipex mini wire cutters, or mini bolt cutters, I should say, work great for snipping wire, especially when you start snipping 1/8 wire and stuff. So now I'm going to run one like this and see if it maybe traps the argon in there a little bit better. I don't know. It's probably not going to be much different, but I'm trying stuff. Thought I'd experiment here a little bit. When you're welding something as thin as 18 gauge, you're going to penetrate a little bit, and you're going to draw a little oxide into the puddle, so it's not going to be a perfectly clean puddle with no purge on the backside. But still, having the chill bars that kind of trap the argon, and then using the tin cup, which kind of help you keep the hot tip of the rod shielded, all go a long way into making something like this look as good as you can make it look. You can see a little bit of oxide floating around here and there in the puddle. Not too bad, though. I really like the way it welded with the chill bars as opposed to without.